Friends of Ralph DeLeon, a Filipino-American accused of involvement in a terror plot, are shocked at the charges against him. Meanwhile, DeLeon's family is still trying to come to terms with his arrest. ABS-CBN North America's Steve Angeles joins us on the line for the latest on this. Hi, Steve.
Hi, Gigi. It is the Thanksgiving holiday in the U.S., and as many families are spending time together at home. However, one family in Ontario, California, is trying to make sense of what federal agents believe their son is a suspected terrorist. In an exclusive interview, I visited and spoke to the father of Ralph DeLeon, the 23-year-old Filipino man who has been accused of attempting to join a terrorist organization to plot jihad against Americans. Mr. DeLeon declined to give his name and asked that his face not be shown. But according to Ralph's father, who works as a care home administrator, despite a 76-page federal affidavit that alleges Ralph and two other friends were planning to move to Afghanistan to become terrorists, the family saw no signs of extremism from Ralph. The family immigrated from Laguna to California in 2002 when Ralph was 13 years old. Their message to me was that as far as they knew and from what they saw, their son lived a normal life and was a typical college student that had an interest in a specific culture, and in this case, that culture was Islam. Ralph went to high school in the U.S. where he excelled in sports, student leadership, and was overall a popular kid. After being raised as a Catholic throughout his life, in 2002, Ralph took an interest in Islam and began converting his faith, though it became a source of friction between him and his family. Ralph's father says they agree to respect each other's beliefs. Mr. DeLeon noticed that after years of a typical youth life, which included partying and late nights, Islam actually brought up a calm and disciplined side of Ralph. Like many, Ralph's father was surprised to hear that his son had been arrested on Friday. As he went home to check on the situation, the FBI was raiding their home. The agents took many of Ralph's belongings, which were affiliated with Islam, such as clothes, documents, books, and posters. And they also took several computers from the home. Gigi.
So, Steve, you said that there were no signs of extremism as far as the parents of Ralph DeLeon were concerned, but did they say if there was any change at all in his routine and his attitude and his outlook in life?
No, they said they noticed the positive changes, like how the Islam faith has a lot of rules, a lot of discipline. They said that Ralph did pray a lot. Ralph, he did have more of his friends that he would meet at the mosque. Over, but they weren't allowed in the house. They made it a rule that religion would not be discussed at the house because it created friction. They wanted him to be Catholic, but they kind of let him do his practices Islam because they saw that it made him quiet. He stopped partying. He stopped. He would just come home early. He would pray, and he would hang out with his friends outside of the house. And they saw no. They didn't see anything wrong with what was going on. They didn't see any violent behavior or notice any sort of, like, terrorist-related activity.
Mm-hmm. And, Steve, did you ask Mr. DeLeon if he's had a chance to visit his son yet after he was arrested?
Yes, he says that, it's very strict to visit federal prisons, but he managed to get one visit in. And the Philippine Consul General also had a separate visit with him. And he spoke to Ralph. He said Ralph still remained in high spirits, and they got to talk about... Ralph never told him about any trips to the Middle East, and he told me that Ralph was just visiting, was planning to do a Muslim pilgrimage to Turkey.
So, in other words, Ralph was denying to his father all the allegations against him in as far as being involved in a plot to bomb American targets.
Yeah, from what Ralph's parents told me, it's like they saw no signs of any terror targets, any joining the Taliban, as the report said. He was just really into his faith, as they described to me.
All right. Well, thank you very much for that update. Steve Angeles there reporting on the Filipino-American who's been accused of involvement in a terrorist plot.